was great because we're away from your home environment, you know, that kind of way. Like, so there's always something to do, you know, in your everyday. Whereas here was very much about just coming here to do music. So it's been nice just to be able to get into that space and do that, you know.
I just always had like this, I mean, I guess a writer's camp's nothing new, but there have been albums made in like secluded places where it was written in a short space of time. And like, we're not necessarily writing an album or anything. I just more like the thought of that, like doing something like that, you know, like the concept of being away somewhere from distractions, focusing on the music together.
Ugh, come on.
Said it could come on.
Yeah, boy, come on. Tweak that shit, yo. Some fucking rolling drums under that. And the thing that drops. Tune's done. Farty. Let's go and have some lunch.
We're out of salmon, though.
Huh?
We're out of salmon, though.
Oh, no.
I need to be in the studio with somebody to catch a vibe, and like you get that instant feedback, like if something's shit, no, that sounds like shit. These in-person collabs are where you can really learn from somebody. Doing it over the internet is just not the vibe for me.
Greg, do you want to cord me up?
Holy cow.
Yeah.
It's a sick cord.
Being here is not necessarily even about the creation, but more about, I don't know, just being together, and I think we could get energy from this experience even after we leave, you know? So it's, for me, it was always more about that.
Get an initial reaction from somebody. So say you walked in, or Sattel walks in, or Lens, or whoever. Like, oh yes, that's really nice. And that's kind of, sometimes you need that reassurance, because when you're off working on your own, a bit of self-doubt creeps in, or you kind of go, oh, is this that good or what, you know? And then you maybe take things out that were good, but you didn't realize, but someone else's ears might go, ah, keep that in, that's, I love it.
You spot something in me that I didn't know was there. And I'm not sure we were where we thought we were.
What's the simple version of this thing? You know what I mean? Sometimes the simplest.
Subtract all the distractions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So good.
Sometimes you try to overcomplicate the thing by adding too much, and sometimes just look at Pharrell Williams' music. It's
the
simplest things, but it's fucking works every time. It's like, you got so much groove.
Yeah.
Where is it going? Shit.
Sorry, man. It's because I'm like, unselecting the channel, basically.
Thank you.
I think I would prefer to do it in two layers because I'm like trying to do a lot.
Okay, so like, you want to record something? Yeah.
Strictly vibes.
When you find that moment, basically that little spark, then you kind of forget everything else that's going on around you, and you just kind of get lost in the moment, don't you? And then like whatever it is, like you need to rush to get the idea down or get the next bit of the idea down or whatever, like you're just totally honed in and focused on that thing, that moment. And I guess, yeah, it's a nice way to kind of forget, like, or get rid of maybe some not so nice thoughts that are going on at that time, if, like, you know, whatever it might be.
What on Clyde? To get into the music, I'm gonna make sure like I got time and no distraction around, because it's gonna be like a Sunday or weekend on my own, or like an evening if I know I got nobody around, you know. But I know if I got my kids or my girlfriend around, it's at some point somebody is gonna ask me something, you know. So even the phone is just like, you know, you flip the phone, you don't see the notification and everything. So I gotta make sure nobody's gonna get into to my way.
Being slightly removed from the hectic urban life is really good for my creativity, but being able to access the big city. So during COVID, it's just, you know how it's been. It's been lockdown after lockdown. And just the quiet just like inspires me. And I think my music is like a combination of these really introspective mellow vibes, but with this epic hands in the air energy that comes with 174 BPM. I've always liked the epicness of drum and bass. That was part of what brought me into it, just like the how fucking epic it is.
I think it's pretty easy for me to accommodate myself anywhere to make music, and I don't know, it's just, I never really think about it either. I just, you know, sit down and do my own shit. I think that's you know, sometimes when I, like when you ask the question, if I think about it, it's just, it feels like being a robot, you know. It's just fucking press button, produce music, and you just start doing this. Yeah. It's just, I don't know, it feels very natural to me to be doing that. And I don't know, it's all right. I think it's cool, especially when you know, have a random idea and you just want to get it down. Just, you know, a couple minutes, save it, and, you know, you can also come back to it later and stuff. But I've never had a problem with, like, starting the ideas or something.
For me, like some people, like Sattel, for example, they've just got this endless fountain of inspiration, but for me, it really comes and goes, you know. Like usually, I work towards a project, like an album or something, and I get quite excited about it, and I find a lot of energy suddenly to finish it. But then when it's finished, my creative juices sort of start to go away for a bit. And I feel like I have to recharge my batteries, creatively speaking. It's more a drive thing, more than an idea thing, I think.
it's the samples, it's creating something that wasn't there with something that was there, if that makes sense. So, you know, you hear an old jazz record and there's like 2.5 seconds of just this tiny little loop that no one else might ever pick up on or even think about. It's just part of a bigger thing. But the heads that are tuned in this way are gonna go, okay, I spot that. I'm gonna try something with that. And then boom, it turns into something. Way I like to work as well, like I like to experiment with stuff, and I don't have a very efficient, if that's possible, way of kind of creating. I like to just try many different things until something's just like, yeah, that's wicked. So it's just like there's not a set path.
I think it might soon be sandwich o'clock.
Yeah, I was thinking the same. Maybe like I was thinking of putting the something with cheese into bagel and putting it into oven.
Shut up. Shut up, bruv. Shut up, bruv. Are you fucking serious? Shut up, bruv.
Because we all live all across the world, mainly in Europe, but all across the world, we only see each other at events, like during COVID. We haven't really seen each other much. So it's just cool being, you know, in a place together where we can look at each other's methods and just kind of get inspiration and vibe of being together. You know, it's like, oh, we're like in some kind of bubble together. Feeding off each other's creativity and just vibes in general. I got you.